This is Sword of the Spirit International Prophetic Ministries.
Just worship the Lord. Come on, is there any worshippers in the house today? Come on, do you know Jesus? Just worship the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Deliverer.
Come on, the fire of God must be today. The Holy Ghost
true and living God. And in His presence is encounter. In His presence is change. Come on. The Bible says that in His presence is a fullness of joy. Come on, just lift up your hands and sign of surrender. You can say, God, whatever you want to do tonight, take control of me. Take control of me. Take control of me. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Jesus.
Jesus!
But I feel the Holy Ghost. I feel the Holy Ghost.
Jesus!
I feel the Holy Ghost. And some chains are going to be broken tonight. I feel the Holy Ghost. She comes to her. Devil, you are a liar. Get off her mind. Get off her mind. Shekababa, you're not going crazy. Shababababa, Sheka. Satan, the blood is against you. Sit there right now. Just sit in His presence right now. Lord, there's something that we do in the prophetic. It's called soaking. You see, it is important to soak. It's important to be still and know that He is God. Because if you be still and you recognize and you look around and you see the magnitude of the blessing, you will see that this God who is for you is more than who is against you. You will see that this God who knows you by name, He is doing what He said in His word. He said in Romans 8:28 that all things are working together for your good. Come on, that devil that's trying to trouble you is working for you. Hallelujah. He's employed by you. Hallelujah. He's turning that thing around by you. Hallelujah. For you. Hallelujah. She's working together for you. Woman of God, the one who was singing before, is it evangelist? When you were singing, the Lord was ministering to me. He says to me that He's given you an honesty and a purity about your worship. And He says to me that as you go around and worship, the quality and the core of your power, of your connection with Him is the purity and the unrestrained worship that you give to Him. He says that you take my worship and you put it in the secret and you bring it public. Amen? And the Lord says, I'm going to elevate you because what you've done in secret is about to be promoted openly. Hallelujah. And the Lord says that because you have chosen me as first place in your heart, that is why I'm opening doors. Hallelujah. But just like I said to my disciples, just like I said to Peter, just like I said to him, do you love me? Do you love me? Do you love me? Because there's going to come a time in your ministry, in your walk, where the enemy is going to come and try to sift you like wheat. But the Lord says that I pray for you and I delivered you and I've risen you up in this season. And your voice will not only cross into this nation, but it will cross nations. It will come across the water. And it will reach to a people who have been disenfranchised with the ministry, who have been disenfranchised with church. People who are looking for an honesty. Your voice represents a new sound that is coming out of the Spirit. God says, I'm raising up worshipers with my heart, not the sound of music. Hallelujah. I'm raising up worshipers with my heart. And the Lord says, keep yourself focused in me in this season. As you go up, let your knees go down more. Hallelujah. As you go further towards me, come deeper. As you go further towards where men lift you. Come deeper towards where I want you. Because I'm going to bring many people around you. Some are wolves in sheep clothing. And some will speak wonderful words, enticing words. But they're not of me, saith the Lord. You will know me. You will know them that are around you. The opportunities I send you. Because I will be put my blueprint. I will put my hand upon those people. And they will speak things that resonate with your heart and your spirit. Hallelujah. By your fruits you shall know them. Come on, give the Lord a worship. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Give Him the glory. Give Him the glory. Give Him the glory. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, isn't God good today, amen? Oh my gosh, I feel the Holy Ghost. Amen. Oh my gosh, I want to kabashikasata. Lord, I thank you. I thank you, 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 God. Thank you, God. We're going to go more into that a little bit later, amen. But I want you to turn your Bibles to Isaiah 62, hallelujah. Isaiah 62. My hallelujahs belong to you, my hallelujahs belong to you. Isaiah 62. My hallelujahs belong to you. My hallelujahs belong to you. Amazing. It says, my hallelujahs belong to you. We don't sing with our mouth, we sing with our hearts, amen. Just say to Him,
my hallelujah belong to you.
It's all your hallelujahs. Just say to Him,
my hallelujah belong to you.
My hallelujah, yeah, yeah.
My hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. I just want you to welcome your neighbor. Just say hello to them. Just bless them. We're in the second day of our conference. Amen. Come on. Isn't God good? Amen. How many of you here were yesterday? Amen. Come on. Did you not know what God did yesterday? Amen. Oh God, I hope you can understand me. I've got an English accent, amen. I said it yesterday. It's a little bit tricky, amen. You say tomato, I say tomato. No, you say tomato, I say tomato. You say potato, I say patata. Potato. Hallelujah. But make sure you welcome your neighbor. You've already done that already. Praise God. We're just happy to be again. I'm happy again to be honored to be with you in the house of the Lord. Amen. Come on, wave your hands if you're happy to be out here in the house of the Lord. Amen. As customary, I want to just thank the Lord for someone I dearly and deeply admire and respect. Amen. In fact, a couple I deeply admire and respect. We haven't known each other long in the flesh, but we've known each other long in the spirit. Amen. And that is your wonderful pastor, Pastor Errol, and his wife, Pastor Angela. Put your hands together for them. Amen. Come on. Praise God for them. Amen. Amen. And due respect given to all the ministers, all the clergy, all the men and women of God. We love you. I love you. You know, we serve together in the house of God. We all have our different functions. Amen. We do have our different callings, but we all have the same boss. Amen.
Amen.
Come on. I'm working for the same guy. Amen.
Yes.
Come on. Amen. There was a little scenario Jesus said. He said to them, the guy complained about one guy getting paid, you know, the same rate as the other guy, you know, and he was saying to him, look, the other guy said, look, I've been working since morning. How come the new guy gets paid the same as I do? Amen? And he had to remind him, listen, you know, it doesn't matter about the pay, amen? It matters about promoting the work of the Lord, amen? Doesn't matter about us, you know, being, you know, what different roles we have. As long as we're connected to the Father and the Father's work is being done. Amen?
Amen.
Come on, wave your hands if you support the Father. Amen?
Amen.
Are you happy? Amen?
Amen.
Glory be to God. So welcome all the men and women of God. I love you. We come send greetings for my church in England. That's where we're based, in London. Our church is called Sword of the Spirit Prophetic Ministries. And, you know, we really want to send love and greetings from them. Amen. Praise God. Come on, today we want to get into the Word of God for real, for real, for real. Tell your neighbor, for real, for real, for real. Hallelujah. Praise God. So if you have your Bibles with me to Isaiah 62, chapter 62, and we're going to go from verse 1. If you have an opportunity to have a Bible, so many people have phones nowadays, but I'm glad most of you are old school, amen. I have to rebuke my church. I say, I'll take your phone if you put it out in church, amen. I'll sell it on eBay and put it in the offering, amen. We need the Word of God, amen. They can download an app that will change your Bible, but this will never change, amen. Glory be to God, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I love you, Lord. Thank you, God. Before we go, let's just pray, Father. Father, thank you, God, for your grace and your mercy, God. Thank you, God, for your presence here tonight, God. Lord, we thank you, oh God, that you are among us, oh God. You are surrounding us tonight. That you are here with us tonight, God. And that we are, Father, Lord, complete in you, oh God, Father. We thank you, oh God, Father, right now for all the wonderful things that you have done and are doing in this place, oh God. I thank you for New Alpha Worship Center, oh God, and where you want to take this church, oh God. For you know every church like you know every person, oh God. And I thank you, oh God, Father, right now for what you're doing here, oh God. Lord, we honor you, we bless you, and we praise you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, church.
Amen.
Come on, church. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, church. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's go straight into it. The Bible says this. At book of Isaiah, verse 62, verse 1. The Bible says, for Zion's sake will I not hold my peace, and for Jerusalem's sake I will not rest, until the righteousness thereof go forth as brightness, and the salvation thereof as a lamp that burneth. Tell someone, burneth. Hallelujah. And the Gentiles shall see thy righteousness, and all the kings thy glory, and thou shalt be called a new name. Hallelujah. Which the mouth of the Lord shall name. Thou shalt be a crown of glory in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of thy God. Thou shalt no more be termed forsaken, neither shall thy land be any more termed desolate, but thou shalt be called Hephzibah. Tell your neighbor, Hephzibah.
Hephzibah.
And thy land Beulah, for the Lord delighteth in thee, and thy land shall be married. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, your land shall be married. Come on, that's the wrong one. Come on, pull to the other one. Say, your land shall be married. Amen. Come on, I'm here to tell you today, your name has changed. Come on, tell the other neighbor, your name has changed. Come on, tell him you're not the same. Your name has changed. Come on, give glory to God. Give him a little hand clap. Amen. Shika. The Bible says that there was a man called Isaiah, and he was known as a prophet of the Lord speaking to a generation. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that, listen, about the prophet, the office of the prophet. The office of the prophet is not so much manifested by the gift, but it's manifested and characterized by the process. Hallelujah. You want to go through the mill before you can run in the office. Amen. You want to go through the campaign before you can get elected. Amen. You want to go through some trouble. Amen. The enemy makes it double. Amen. But after that, a broken man comes out and is able to be the mouthpiece of God. Hallelujah. Amos 3 verse 7 says, surely the Lord God will do nothing unless he reveals it to his servants, the prophets. Hallelujah. You see, something was revealed to Isaiah. Something was manifested in his time. He came with the word to Jerusalem. At the time when the word was being given, Jerusalem was a city that was running but was spiritually poor. Amen. You may have God looking, you may be looking good on the outside, but on the inside, everything's going trouble, amen. Everything's going problems, amen. You may be smiling on the outside, but God knows on the inside your sorrow, amen. You may be screaming, jumping and screaming in church, but when you go home, things ain't good. When you go to school, things ain't good. When you go to work, things ain't good. You're troubled in your spirit, hallelujah. But that's when the Lord who stoops high and stands high, stoops low and sees high, came down and said, I'm going to send my prophet to give them a word. Tell somebody today you need a word. You need a
word, be the word.
And you see, the prophet came and saw Jerusalem. Even in the natural, though, it was good. But in the spirit, it needed to say that you need to wake up and arise because something is about to happen to you. Amen? You see, people look on the outward appearance. God goes past the outward appearance. He looks at the heart of the individual. He looks at what's going on the inside. You could be smiling at me with all your 32 teeth. Amen? But you may hate me deep down. Amen? You may shake my hand. Amen? When I'm gone, you're ready to cast me. Amen? You see, people think that they're good at pretending with people, but you can't pretend with God. Hallelujah. When God looks at a person, he's not looking at what you present him. Amen. He's looking at the hidden part. Amen. He says, I'm the Lord who sees in secret. I'm going to take that secret that you're hiding. I'm bringing it out open. Amen. I'm sending the prophets to show you. Amen. What you've been doing dirty, I'm going to bring it out. Hallelujah. And he said, Jerusalem, you're meant to be peaceful with me, but you're in animosity with me because your spirit is too bad. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that when the word came forth to Jerusalem, it was at a place where the Bible was saying about, it was telling him that for Zion's sake, God would not hold his peace. Hallelujah. God was expressing his heart to his people. He says, I'm not holding my peace. I can't be rested unless my people are blessed. Amen. I can't be comfortable with my people in bondage. I can't be comfortable with my people's spirit low. I can't be comfortable. I've got to release a word. I've got to send a prophet. I've got to release a man. I've got to send them. The Bible says, how can they hear the gospel unless they are sent? Amen. I've got to raise up a generation. I'm going to raise up a people. I'm going to call an ecclesia, a called out people who know me by name. And I'm going to send them. I'm going to equip them. And I'm going to build them. Amen. Because I can't rest if my people are low. Hallelujah. Come on, tell your neighbor, I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. Hallelujah. And you see, because there was a trouble in the land, a prophet was raised up. You see, you've got to be a prophet with a purpose, amen? You've got to have a purpose, amen? It can't be about the flashy gift and title and looking about. We've got to be ministers with a purpose, amen? We've got to say, look, we're not here to be served, amen? We're here to serve, amen? We're not here to be given lofty positions, amen? We're here to get low and dirty with it, amen? Because we need to help you, hallelujah! Amen. That's what he was looking for, amen? So when the Bible says that the word was released, the Bible knows that God knew that, listen, you ain't got a problem. You ain't got an issue. You just ain't got a lack of the word. Amen? He said the people don't have an issue deep down, but they don't have a revelation of my word. They don't have a revelation of who I am. They don't have a revelation of what I bring. Amen? You see, when you have a revelation of God, amen, you don't worry about problems. You praise through problems. When you have a revelation about who God is, you don't look about what people say. You look about what he says. Amen. When you have a revelation about what he's doing, your face can't stay upside down. You have to get that frown. You gotta turn it upside down. You gotta say, God, listen, I know you called me. I know you're with me. I know you're standing by me. And I can't be upset. Amen. Listen, weeping, trouble may come through the night, but my joy is coming in the morning. The word was released. Amen. You see, the Bible, come on, hallelujah, I need some help here, hallelujah. The Bible said, listen, that when the word, in the beginning was the word, John 1, and the word was God, and the word was with God, amen? But you see, the word couldn't just stay in the spirit. It had to manifest into the natural. It had to come out of spirit and to manifest, amen? Because God says, so, I love the world so much that I'm going to give, amen? When you love somebody, you give, amen? When you love someone, you give, amen? When you love something, you take care of your own self and say, how can I bless you? Amen. And God said, listen, I'm not going to stand by. I'm restless. My people are crying. The problems are happening. The bills are pouring up. I'm restless. I'm troubled. Amen. Son, you got to go. And the Bible says the word got up from the spirit and began to walk towards the earth. And it began to come and pour into the spirit of Mary. And Mary standing. We can do understand that she was carrying the word. Amen. She was carrying change. Amen. And the word was birthed out and became flesh. Amen. They do not understand why the the word needed to be flesh, amen? Because listen, God wants you to be see the word instead of hearing the word, amen? He said, I'd rather you be doers of the word than just hearers only, amen? Come on, I'm speaking to somebody. I'd rather you understand as a minister that you are trying here to help and do the word, not just preach the word, not just say the word, not just act the word, but listen, you want to be the word, you want to walk the word, you want to talk the word, you want to shout the word, you want to jump the word, you want to clap the word, because everything is about you, it's supposed to be about the word. Come on, tell your neighbor, it's about the word. That's what he was trying to say. Listen, the word needs to be released, amen? They didn't need help. They needed the word, amen? Your situation doesn't need more prayer. It needs the word, amen? You got to make sure you're in line with the word, amen? Because Jesus said, if you love me, why don't you do what I say, amen? Why aren't you word-based? Why aren't you biblical? Why aren't you worshiping like I said? I told you I got this. I told you I'm for you. I told you I'm sorting it out. I told you, be strong and be of good courage. Come on, because I have overcome the world, amen? Be of good cheer, hallelujah. Why ain't you worrying, amen? He goes, listen, you guys think you need a prophetic word, but really you need a revelation of who I am, amen? If you knew who I was, I'm a lawyer in the courtroom, hallelujah. I'm a deliverer, I'm a way maker, hallelujah. His desire began to release the word. And when the word was released, the Bible says that the word manifests and becomes flesh. Amen. He said, listen, Jesus said this, when you see a mountain, don't run away from a mountain. Speak to the mountain and tell it to go back into the sea. Come on, how many of you speak to your mountains? Amen. Are you ready to speak to your mountains? Amen. Are you, do you understand you can talk to a mountain? Amen. He said, life and death is in the power of your tongue. He that loves it, do you love it? Amen. Come on, you can eat the fruit thereof. You can say to a mountain, come out, go here and go back to throw it up there on the side. Amen. Because something is about to happen when you speak. Tell your neighbor, you're about to speak. Come on, man. I'm not in England, amen. Come on, I'm in the USA. Come on, bless the name of Jesus. Shakabo surra bakasata. Shikarabo surra bakasata. Shikata basata. Shikabo surra bakasata. And the Bible says that when the word gets into a person, he does not become the same creature. He becomes a new man. Hallelujah. You see, all things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Hallelujah. He was trying to tell you that you're a new creature. Hallelujah. But the Bible also says, so as a man think in his heart, so is he. Hallelujah. The devil's trying to convince you you're still the same. That's why he sends the bad three friends to come and convince you that you ain't changed. You ain't changed, but you've changed. Amen. The moment you said, yes, Lord, you changed. The moment you said, yes, God, you've changed. Amen. The moment you stepped into Christ, you became a new creature. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that when we get a new creature, we have a new heavenly identity, a new heavenly reality. Shakabasata. You see, that's what made Jesus God. It wasn't the flesh, it was the spirit. He had a different spirit. You see, they sent out 12 spies into the land, and 12 spies came back, and 10 had a report, but 2 had a report. They looked at Joshua and Caleb, and the Bible says, you guys got a different spirit. Hallelujah. You see, you need a different spirit to overcome the demons that are on the land. Amen. You need a different personality. You need a personality that says, God, listen, if your word says it, I believe it. God, if your word mentions it, I'm going to take it. God, if your word speaks it, I'm going to have it. Hallelujah. Shikaba, you guys, I'm preaching better than your amen. Hallelujah. Come on. Don't let the guy from England out preach it today. Amen. Come on. Come on. Somebody praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Shikaba Sitika. And so he said to him, listen, because the word has impregnated you, James 1:21 says you need to get the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul. You need the engrafted word. You just don't need any word. You need a word. You need to get that word. You need to get into that word. You just say that word again and again. Hallelujah. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I am the head and not the tail. Come on, come on. I'm above and not beneath. The weapon formed the fashion against me, it can't prosper. Come on. God, Lord, for this is my heritage, from the righteousness of me, saith the Lord. You are looking to the mirror of the word of God, and you're going to see your identity. And you see, the Bible says when you look into the mirror of God, and you begin to sit with God, and when you look with God, all of a sudden, his glory, which is his doxa, which is his opinion, opinion becomes who, what you are, amen. God's opinion of you comes out in your life, amen. Listen, when they said you couldn't shine, you begin to shine, amen. When they said you couldn't go, you begin to go, amen. When they said you couldn't stand, you begin to stand, amen. When they said you couldn't shout, you begin to shout, amen. Because God's glory is all on you. Verse 3, amen. And he says to him, listen. Verse 2, hallelujah. And he says, listen, because the word has been spoken, you shall have a new name, which the mouth of the Lord shall name. Amen. The prophet came to give you a new name. Hallelujah. The Jesus came to give you a new name. Hallelujah. He came to give you a name that matches who God says you are. Hallelujah. Jesus died on the cross so that you can be made one with the Father. Amen. No longer are you an orphan. No more. Your name is no longer orphan, but you're a son and daughter of the Most High God. In fact, the Bible says you are a royal priesthood, a chosen generation. Hallelujah. And these kings come into a place. Hallelujah. When you're a king, you have a different set of authority than when you're a prince and then when you're a servant. I tell people in my church, don't come with me in any Mickey Mouse prayer. When you go into prayer, you go into prayer. You come into prayer like a champion, amen? You're going to be bold and walk into the throne of God with boldness, amen? One time someone came to me and said, man of God, I'm having a problem. I said, come on, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of the Lord. Please, please help me. I said, what are we doing? Amen. We either have a problem or you have a problem. Amen. Because I know when my house is burning, I'm running out of the house. What do I have? Amen. I see people come to church like it's a holiday camp. Amen. Let's see who sings best today. If I feel it, I might. Whether you feel it or you don't feel it, it's time to go to war. Amen. Come on, how many warriors do I have? Amen. Whether you know it or you don't know it, it's time to go to war. Amen. I said you can't play around. Amen. If you don't know how your identity in Him, then you have no authority in Him. Amen. Your identity is licensed to your authority. This is why he says, listen, your name must be changed. Hallelujah. And the Bible says this, look at verse 4, Isaiah 3, verse 4. Thou shalt no more be termed forsaken, neither shall your land be termed desolate, but you shall be called Hephzibah. Hallelujah. When you put the word on yourself, when you put the word in your spirit, you become a new person. You become beautiful to God. Come on, God loves you. Hallelujah. The word Hephzibah means he delights in you. Hallelujah. He delights in her. Hallelujah. He doesn't see your brokenness. He don't see your cussing anymore. He don't see your issues anymore. He sees the blood all over your face. Amen. He sees the promise all over your face. Amen. And the Bible said he delights in you. He wants to know you. He wants to come close to you. Come on, we're talking about love worth sharing. Amen. The love was shed from above. Amen. And it was poured over your face. Amen. Tell your neighbors, on your face, it's on your face. Is on your face. Hallelujah. 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 And the Bible says this, and it says, and thy land Beulah, your land Beulah, your name will be changed to Hephzibah, and your land Beulah, which means married. Shakaba Sata. I'm about to get you all connected in a minute. Amen. You're about to get it in a minute. Hallelujah. He says, for the Lord delights in thee, and thy land shall be married. You see, he's trying to say something. He's trying to say, I put my word into the atmosphere, not so that you can just get the word and receive the benefits of the word, but I want the word to be connected to you. Amen. I want the word to be in you. Hallelujah. I want the word to guide you. In fact, I want to walk with you. I want to talk with you. I want to stand with you. I don't want you just to be able to know the word, come in the church and playing around with it. I want to carry you through the journey. Amen. I want to reconnect what was missing in the garden. Amen. You see, with Adam and Eve sin, the Bible says sin became between God and between man. Hallelujah. And the Bible says now we're reconnected. Now we're reconciled to God. There's a connection being made. We're married. Hallelujah. You see, when I'm married to God, hallelujah. You see, whatever is his is mine, and whatever is mine is his. Hallelujah. You see, when I had some brokenness, it became his. Amen. When I had some problems, it became his. Amen. When I had some poverty, it became his. Amen. And there's a divine exchange in the realm of the spirit. Amen. He traded my beauty, his beauty for my ashes. Amen. He traded his problems for my problems for his solutions. Amen.
And you see, I became married, amen? I'm married to God, amen? I'm connected to God, amen? Because I'm married, I can't go to the bar with you no more. Because I'm married, I can't go to the club with you no more. Because I'm married, I can't hang around with the boyfriend no more. I can't hang around with the girlfriend no more. I'm in a relationship with the Lord, amen? I'm connected to the Lord, amen? I'm a new person, amen? My last name has changed for a Lord, amen? Because the Bible says the Maker, is your husband, amen? And he said, listen, I'm ready to take you into your new place, amen? For when you get married, the Bible says a woman, a man must leave his father and his mother. I left the natural mother, I left the natural father, and I'm cleaving unto Jesus. I'm cleaving unto Jesus because I'm married, hallelujah. And because I'm married, amen, the Bible says I inherit the destiny and the purposes of God. Come on. Come on. God said this is a love worth sharing, because listen, when you are married to me, not only do you get my divine benefits, but you get my name. Come on, come on, come on. Come on. You get my name, amen. You get my authority, amen. You get my position, amen. You get to dominate, amen. You get to trample on serpents and scorpions, amen. You get to trample on every weapon of the enemy, amen. You get the power of the Holy Ghost, amen. Listen, you're not just getting half of it. You're not getting three quarters. You're getting the whole lot, amen. God said, listen, tonight is your night. Well, you need to take it back, amen. Because you ain't married, you ain't single, you're married, hallelujah. You need to recognize you got someone looking for you. You got someone hunting for you. God says, I'm restless, amen. I need to find my bride. I'm looking for the bridegroom. I'm looking for the person that beautifies their face with the word of God, amen. And I'm coming back. I'm coming back. I'm coming back. Tell your neighbor, he's coming back. Shikaba sitika. Vishikaba babashiki sitika. Hishikabasa. You see, when you're married to God, amen, it's different from being engaged to God or dating God, amen. When I'm dating somebody, I'm looking for information to see if I want to continue the relationship, amen. Praise God. When I'm engaged to God, it means that I'm saying yes, but I'm not really yes yet, amen. But when I'm married, I'm committed, I'm all the way in. Hallelujah. Listen, I'm looking for people that are all the way in this season. I'm not looking for the lukewarm, amen. If you're hot, I want you. If you're cold, I don't mind you. But if you're lukewarm, I'm spewing you out in this season, hallelujah. Because there's a separation happening in the realm of the spirit where God is raising up the true church, and the true church needs to stand up at this time, hallelujah. Because the end times are coming where God, where the enemy will come, and the people of the devil, the people of the end time, the people of the Antichrist will raise up deceiving many. But I need my church to stand up. I need the people who love me to stand up. I need to see my brides. I need to see my husbands. I need to see those that love me. Come on, it's not about what I've done for you. I've given too much for you, but do you love me? Hallelujah. That's what he's saying to us tonight. Do you love me? Do you want me? Do you need me? Hallelujah. Come on, just worship him wherever you are. Come on, just worship him wherever you are. Just worship him wherever you are. Come on, you're married to the Holy Ghost. You're married to the power of God. Hallelujah. The Bible says you are new. Hallelujah. You are sanctified. You are set free. Come on. Just worship him right now. Hallelujah. 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 There needs to be a change in your mindset. There needs to be a change in your attitude. There needs to be a change in your positioning. Because you're going higher in this season. Hallelujah. You're going further in this season. Hallelujah. Come on, I want you to stand up on your feet. Hallelujah. Come on, begin to worship the Lord of me. Begin to worship the Lord of me. Come on, begin to worship the Lord of me. Shikababa. Shikababa. Hishikababa. Because you're married with God. Because you're connected with God. Because you're in relationship with God. The Bible says the authority of God, the power and dominion of God is in your hand. Hallelujah. Come on, tonight we need to speak to the mountain. Hallelujah. We need to speak to the barren land. Jesus spoke to the dry bones. Hallelujah. Come on, you need to speak as like Ezekiel, you speak to the dry bones. Come on, I want you to open your mouth and speak right now. Anything that is desolate, anything that's been forsaken, come on, begin to speak into the atmosphere right now. Lord, Father, we come, Father. We come to you, God, for we have been given a new name, God. We've been given a new destiny, God. We've been given a new territory, God. Come on, I want you to open your mouth. Come on, speak to the mountain tonight. Speak to the mountain tonight. Father, we speak to every mountain. We speak to every issue, God. We speak to every circumstance, God. We ask you to move in your power tonight. We ask you to move in your glory tonight, God. Release, Father, let a fresh anointing tonight. Release a fresh power tonight. The Lord, when he stay in the spirit. The Lord, when he spoke to Jerusalem, the prophet was sent to Jerusalem. It's because Jerusalem was present, but was not active. It was not in the right spiritual position. And some of us here, we are present, but we're very weary. We've been tired. And we're tired. But God says, if you knew who you are, if you knew who you are, if you remember who you are, strength will arise. Come on, just ask the Lord to fill you tonight. Come on, just ask the Lord to fill you tonight. Come on, ask the Lord to fill you tonight. You're chosen by the King. Ask him to fill you tonight. You're chosen by the King. Ask him to use you tonight. Jesus. Thank you, God. Those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up wings like eagles. Yes, Lord, they shall run and not be weary. Lord, restore right now. Restore right now, God. Come on, church, let's encounter. Let's press in. Come on, church, let's press in. Worship him. I see the angels of God pouring out right now. Pouring out, Shukababa. Lord, Father, pour out, God. Pour out into your children, God. Father, where they've been weary, where they've been hurt, where they've been bound, oh God, right now. Give them strength, oh God. Shukababa. I see some have been wounded. Some of you have been wounded. The word that you received was there to destroy you. It wasn't the word that heals you. The word of the enemy has come before the word of the Lord. And sometimes the word of the enemy sends scars in our spirit. And the Lord says, I'm healing that wound tonight. Come on, if you can just cry again to him. He's healing that wound, David. He's healing that disappointment, spirit of disappointment loose of your people. The room is quaking away your voice, but your voice is coming back. Your name is coming back. They labeled you with an old name, but the Lord says you've got a new name again. You're not what the devil said you are. You're not what the enemy has labeled you as. Lord, repair. Lord, restore tonight. Lord, heal the broken hearted tonight. God, right now, release your healing, God.
Jesus.
to pray for some people tonight. If you know that's your heart that's been heavy, you've been burdened. If you know your heart's been heavy, you've been burdened. I want to call you up to the front, eh? God says, I want to trade. I want to trade tonight. I want to repair tonight. The altar is the place of exchange. The altar is the place of exchange. Some of you have been carrying too much things. You've been carrying. It's on your back. You've been carrying. But God says, even though you say that, even though you know you're married, you still feel discouraged. I want to invite you to come forward. Come on, with everybody else is just worshiping. Come on, let's not watch. Let's pray. Come on, let's worship God. If it's you, if you're not coming forward, then let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. Let's keep this atmosphere. Come on, lift your hands to Jesus. Lift your hands to Jesus. Oh, I want to hear you tonight. Oh, I want to change you. Come on, just worship Him. Just worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Come on, something's happening tonight. Come on, something's happening tonight. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord Father, I loose every spirit of disappointment. Father, right now, every spirit of heartache, oh God, Father, right now, cleanse your daughter. Right now, release that right now from every burden, oh God. Every burden, oh God. Strength arise in her spirit today, God. Lord, right now, God, I pray, God, that you release your Holy Ghost fire to restore and to repair, oh God. The Lord says everything that the enemy's stolen from you is coming back in this season. Where you've been robbed in the spirit, certain blessings, divine mandates were meant to be apportioned to you. And the Lord says that the enemy has come and he's almost, you feel like the enemy making a mockery out of your worship. But the Lord says, no, I have heard thy cry, my daughter, and I'm releasing and I'm repairing all what the enemy stole back. He that swallowed up riches is about to vomit. Lord, in the name of Jesus, look at, you're pregnant with your miracles. You're about to release. Come on, 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 I cancel the chains right now. I break the chains right now. Release her feet right now. Loose her feet right now. Miracle in your finances. Lord, I release that miracle in her finances, God. I release that miracle in her finances, God. Come on, worship. Come on, brothers, what's the move tonight? Don't block you from moving tonight. Come on, wherever you are, worship. Move your hands to Jesus. Worship. Wherever you are, worship. Lord Father, I pray, Father, Lord Father, that you release, oh God, the mantle, oh God, Father, of acceleration, oh God. Lord, where he has been stuck, oh God, where he has been limited, oh God, where, Father, right now he hasn't seen the mantle, the provision and the fruits, oh God. Lord, I pray right now today, oh God, whatever chain, whatever yoke was loose holding him, oh God. Lord, I thank you, oh God, Shabba Baba Kasata. Lord, in the area of relations, family, Shabba Baba Baka. Lord Father, I send repair in the family, oh God. Send repair in the home, oh God, Father. Lord, I pray, oh God, you use him, oh God, Father. Lord, when he feels his voice has been made small, oh God. Lord, I magnify his voice in the realm of the Spirit, God. I pray, oh God, Father, he will begin to speak, oh God. He will begin to speak as a man of authority. He will begin to speak as a man of influence, oh God. We have caused him, oh God. We have evangelized him, oh God. When the city is small, oh God. Lord, and release, oh God, Father, his tongue, oh God. Right now, oh God, Father, shakababa. Man of God, the Lord says, come forward. Man of God, the Lord says, come forward. Come on, Basha. Because the limits to you. Alababa. They're not your limits, hallelujah. But not what I said upon your life, amen. From your child, I've given you ideas. I've given you industry. I've given you a mind to think great things, hallelujah. He says, take a leap of faith in this season. Take a leap of faith in this season. Come forward and know me this season. Come deeper and find me this season. But I'm bringing you higher. I'm bringing you further. I'm bringing you deeper in me. Your name, I'm making your name great, amen. Only let go of the crowd. Only let go of the people. Only come away from them and be separate. Because I'm moving you to a new territory. A mantle of glory is released upon you. A mantle of glory is released upon you. A mantle of glory is released upon you. Holy Ghost, touch him right now. Release it right now, God. Bless him right now, God. Come on, church, worship him tonight. I will send sons and daughters from afar that you can chop up this soka. They're gonna come and sit. Chop up that. I'm gonna bring them from afar. I'm gonna bring sons and daughters from the east, the south, the north, and the west. Come on, lift your hands if you don't worship, you worship.
This is Sword of the Spirit International Prophetic Ministries.
That represented his mantle.
Prophetess Kavane Rankin.
What God was going to do in his life. How God was going to set him apart from the rest of his brothers.
Come worship with us Sundays 5 p.m. Thursdays 8 p.m. We're located at 1 Marsh Road, Alberton, London, HA01ES.